All right. My name is Shahzad Ali, and I am the NSX Solutions Architect. My role and responsibility is to make sure that customers are deploying NSX and designing NSX successfully. In this part of the presentation, I'm going to cover NSX monitoring and troubleshooting. Because oftentimes, when I'm talking to customers, they ask me, if I deploy NSX or virtual network, am I going to lose visibility inside my network or inside my virtual machine? And my answer is very plain, simple, and straightforward. And that's not true, because NSX is a standard-based solution, IP-based solution. You can easily integrate NSX into your existing processes and the servers that you have. For example, NSX, all NSX components, they do support syslog. So if you already have a syslog server, or if you have LogInsight, for example, you can easily push the log to the syslog server, and then you have the visibility, right? So that is one point I wanted to emphasize on. And there is a reason for that, because being part of vSphere stack gives us some advantages. First of all, NSX is part of vSphere, and we are sitting close to the virtual machine. So being close to the virtual machine, when the packet leaves the virtual machine and before even it hits the vNIC, we can see things at the kernel level, right? So this is providing us greater visibility inside the packet that your hardware vendor cannot even provide, right? And the second advantage is that, you know, this is all in software, right? So being in software as a software solution, the advantages that you get with the software comes with the NSX product. For example, with vSphere, you have vMotion, HA capabilities, or a snapshot. You can easily take a snapshot of a virtual machine, or you can export the entire configuration of NSX and ship it to us, for example. We can recreate your issue in our lab, and we can solve your problem. So these are the reasons that NSX can easily be operated and managed into your network. And the last point I want to make here is that, you know, with NSX and with vSphere, we are giving you single entry point into your software-defined data center. So you can not only manage and operate your virtual compute, your storage, but now you can also manage and operate your virtual network. There are many various features that I can highlight here, but I will keep my focus on these three tools that are very specific to VDS and NSX. Number one is VXLAN ping, traceflow, and host-level packet capture. So let's take a look at VXLAN ping. So VXLAN ping is a tool that we use that can test the connectivity between your VTAPs or VXLAN tunnel endpoints. Why is it important? Let's say you get a call from your customer or your client, and he says that my application on VM1 cannot talk to application on VM2. The first thing that you will do, you will log into the guest virtual machine, VM1, and then you will initiate a regular ping between VM1 and VM2. If the ping is failing at that level, the next thing that you should do is to make sure that your VXLAN connectivity is there. And for that reason, you're going to use VXLAN ping. So in order to demonstrate how does it work in the background in our software, I have set up this network for you. So in the bottom, I have top of the rack switches shown in gray. And then these top of TOR switches are running three different subnets for VTAP connectivity. So I have host A, B, part of subnet X, CD, part of subnet Y, and EF, part of subnet Z, as you can see here. So in any network, in any Ethernet-based network, you have two types of traffic. One is the unicast, second is the BUM traffic, broadcast, non-unicast, and multicast. So if it is a unicast scenario, it is very easy. VM1 trying to send a packet to VM2, host A knows about the location of VM2 because NSX controller knows about it, and it's going to send it over to VM2 using the same logical switch A. But the broadcast is handled differently in NSX platform. It happens in two stages. So in stage one, host A will send a local copy to all the hosts in subnet X, and it will also send a copy to a remote subnet, for example, subnet Y and subnet Z. Now it is the responsibility of that particular host to replicate it to its local subnet, all the hosts in the local subnet. So that is the reason we call it a two-stage process. So that is how it works in the background in case of VXLAN ping. And that is the reason we provide you two different options in the NSX GUI. One is the unicast, and second is the broadcast VXLAN ping. So let me show you a demo of how it works from the workflow or from the GUI point of view. So what I have configured here in the lab, basically I have two hosts, host A with .196 and host B with .199. I'm going to ping from host B to host A using logical switch, red logical switch. As you can see, this red logical switch is not extended all the way to host A, so my ping will fail in that situation. In the second demo, second part of the demo, I will be using the same source and destination host, but this time using green logical switch. And this time the ping will succeed. So pay attention here, it's going to go quick. So I'm going to click logical switch here, and I'm going to use subnet 20, red logical switch. I have selected in the destination. And I will start my test here, and it fails because it's a red logical switch. Now let's take a look at what happens with the green logical switch. So green logical switch is extended to both hosts, and this time the ping should be successful. Right, so I did the test here. And you can see the ping is successful. This is a scenario if you have an NSX cluster already prepared and you added a new host in the cluster, and for some reason your logical switch is not extended all the way to the other host. In that type of situation, you should use this tool. That is what we recommend. That second tool, which is more powerful than this tool, is called the Traceflow tool. This is what we introduced with NSX 6.2 very recently. So this tool allows you to see how your packet is traveled inside our software stack, inside NSX software stack. This is very similar to a situation where you ship a package from source to destination using FedEx or DHL. So FedEx or DHL has a tracking enabled. It will tell you exactly what happened to your packet at every stage. This is a very similar scenario here. So as an admin, you will log into vCenter, and then you will say, I want to trace a packet flow between host A and host B. Your NSX manager will receive the information and will feed it into the NSX controller. And remember, this is a special trace flow packet. An NSX controller responsible for host A, in this case, will send it to the relevant hypervisor, telling the hypervisor that, Mr. Hypervisor, this is a special packet. You need to inject it into the network on this VM's behalf. So this is a special packet, as you can see in number 3. This goes to the destination, and while it is traveling inside the software stack, it's reporting back all the observation back to the controller. So the controller is receiving the information, and it feeds it into NSX Manager, and you see it in a nice GUI fashion. So I'm going to show you a small demo again. So this time, I have two short demos. In demo number 1, I'm going to use the green logical switch and those two virtual machines, VM1 and VM2, they are part of the same logical switch. So you will see that there will not be any distributed router involved in that packet flow. In the second flow, it's a ping between or traffic flow between two different virtual machines, and you're going to see there will be a distributed router in between. Okay, so demo number 1 without any DLR. I go there, the GUI, click on the trace flow, and now I'm going to select my source virtual machine and that particular NIC on source virtual machine, because you could have multiple NICs on a VM. Okay. Now I'm selecting the destination. VM2 on the same logical switch. And trace. So you can see here in this diagram that it is telling exactly what happened to that packet. So it left the VNIC in sequence number 0. In sequence number 1, it is hitting a firewall. And this is the power of NSX, that your firewall is attached next to the virtual machine. This is where the microsegmentation benefit comes into the picture. Goes into the firewall module inside the kernel, checks the rule, and then leave the firewall, and then go to the source VTAP and then to the destination VTAP. And then it hits the firewall again, right? So you see the firewall, it is attached next to the virtual machine. So that was without the DLR in between. Same logical switch, simple. In the next demo, source is the same. The destination VM is VM3. And this VM3 is on a different logical switch. So now this trace flow should go through a DLR. So this is what you see here, a distributed logical router. And you can see the power of this tool, how it operates in the GUI and how it shows you the output. And this is what we recommend for you to use. The third tool is basically goes really deep down inside the packet inspection. It's like the crime scene investigation or forensic report, creating a forensic report of what happened to the packet. So there are two important points I want to mention. Number one, with this tool, this is a CLI-based tool. You can use capture points. So you can say, where do you want to capture the packet? Is it at the VNIC level? Is it at the uplink level or at the VDS level? So you specify the capture point first. And the second thing that you do, you basically specify the filters, right? So the filter will decide, okay, you want to capture HTTP traffic or VXLAN traffic, for example, in this case. So once you configure that, enter the command, the CLI command, and you can see the output right on the CLI itself. The nice thing about this tool is that you can export the output in a PCAP file. So you can feed it into the Wireshark analyzer, for example, and you can see it in a nice GUI format. We have a session, NET 5488, that goes more in depth about this tool. It's on Thursday. Okay, so now these are the miscellaneous best practices that we always recommend to our customer. Number one is security, right? So once you have deployed NSX. NSX comes with great security options. Although you have the security ACL and PVLAN option in VDS, but we recommend you to use the security distributed firewall that comes with NSX. Quality of service, really important. If your guest virtual machine needs quality of service, we recommend you to mark them with the DHCP value. That DHCP value is copied to the outer VXLAN header. And then once that packet goes to the physical network, you should have your physical network configured for the right priority, and then it will get the right priority based on what you configured. MTU requirement. MTU is basically not a requirement. It is a must that you should have at least 1600 bytes configured on your physical network. And this is because VXLAN is adding 50 bytes of encapsulation there. NIC. NIC card selection is very important. This is where the performance comes into the picture, and I have seen it with many of customers where they did not use a proper VNIC and their performance suffered. So we recommend that you use a VNIC that can offload your VXLAN in hardware. Okay, so we are going towards the conclusion. See, these are the key takeaways that I want to highlight. Number one, VDS is the key component of NSX platform, and it is the only virtual switch that is supported with NSX. Number two, VXLAN and VDS technologies, they are decoupling your physical network with the virtual network. So that is important. You can easily create network as long as you have basic IP connectivity. You can do wonders in software. And the last point I want to mention is that VDS is deployed in a large scale deployments. I have deployed it for one of my customers, Columbia Sports, recently, and it is there out there, and it's being used successfully. All right. So these are the ecosystem partners we have. This is a slide that's just a reference. You should keep it with you. Basically, what we are telling you here that we work with any vendor. These are the resources that we have provided to educate you. My best favorite is HOL, hands-on lab. I highly recommend you go ahead and take the HOL labs for NSX. And that is the end of the presentation. Thanks for joining. I hope you enjoy the rest of the show.